Well, I have been informed that Larry is not here this morning. We welcome Eric, and Eric's going to also do a piece after worship as a postlude, Chopin Scherzo. So you'll want to stick around and hear him. I think I heard part of it this morning, and it was fantastic. So I hope you guys will stick around for our postlude. Good morning, post-Easter. How are we going? How are we doing? Let's stand, greet two people you don't know, and talk about your favorite shoes. What's your favorite shoes? I don't know. I don't know what's that. We sing together. This is a song called Waymaker. I know there's a lot of us here that coming off that Easter high, and we hit the reality this week, and we kind of need to hear that our God is a waymaker. Moving when we don't see it, working when we don't feel it. That's who our God is. Amen. So we sing together. You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Listen to those words right now this morning. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are here. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, mending every heart. I worship you. I worship you. For you are a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Sing to God this morning. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. That's who. That is who you are. That is who you are. Yes, God, that is who you are. That is who you are. That is who. That is who you are. 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 You are way maker. You are way maker. Miracle worker. Promise keeper. Light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Sing to God, you are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Who needs to hear about a miracle this morning? Amen. All those things that stand in front of us, that block our way,
They ain't got nothing on us today. Cause even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. Sing that, just never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, even when I told. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, for you are waymaker, waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Sing it for those who can't sing. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Sing, that's who you are. That is 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 who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Sing for those who can't sing. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Amen, church.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter and our joy. Amen. Look, here is water. Here is our water of life. Alleluia. Immersed in the promises of baptism, let us give thanks for what God has done for us. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your voice thundered over the deep, and the water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve beheld Eden's verdant rivers. The ark carried your creation through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people passed through the sea into freedom's land. In a desert pool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Look, here is water. Here is our water of life. Hallelujah. At the river, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciling love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you through the risen Christ, our source of living water, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Look, here is water.
What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing can stand against the beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, kneeling, standing, or sitting as you feel called. Your church cries out, O God, and you listen. As you drew near to the disciples, draw near to us this day. Breathe on us, your Holy Spirit, that our faith is renewed and we witness to your love. Open our hearts to discern where God calls each of us to serve. Your world cries out, O God, and you listen. Bring your Spirit where people are crying out because they see war in their backyards, especially Israel, Palestine, Russia, and Ukraine. Guide police, firefighters, paramedics, and other first responders to work for the well-being of communities and the dignity of every person, that no one may need to live in fear.
What a beautiful name it is.
Your children cry out, O God, and you listen. Hear your people crying out for justice, for an end to racism and other oppression, and for a world where all are fed and safe. We pray for all who cry out in suffering and pain. Your congregations cry out, O God, and you listen. With gratitude in our hearts, for the love of those who now rest in you, we remember them, especially those we name aloud at this time. Grant us your peace amid our fears. We pray for those that need your healing. Lay your hands on us and bring wholeness to those that suffer from cancer, chronic illness, depression, physical disorder, mental illness, and all sickness. We pray for those on our congregational prayer list and those that we name aloud at this time. Into your hands, most merciful God, we give to you all who are in our hearts and on our mind, trusting in your abiding love, through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. And we sing our Amen.
What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name is the name of Jesus.
What a beautiful
name it is the name of Jesus. What a beautiful name it is the name of Jesus.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. Share now the peace of Christ with one another, and we'll let our little ones head out for Cross and Crown Kids. Church, he is risen. The season of Easter is fantastic. Obviously, I think probably the folks that packed the house last week didn't get the memo that we still also do church the following Sunday. Yeah. Oh, it's spring break. So many folks were gone on spring break. A lot of folks left, and they're gone through this weekend, including some of our musicians. We're so grateful to have Eric step in while Larry's away, enjoying a little bit of time, and it's just awesome to be here as a congregation. The thing that we always say to each other, if it's been a long time since you've been here, or it's the first time you're here, maybe you just need the reminder as a congregation member. We say this together, one, two, three.
Welcome home.
If you're looking for a church home, we hope you just walked into it. This is a fantastic place to be. And I don't know, reasonably nice people, I would say. Like, pretty good. We love to eat. We love to commune. We love to be together. It's a fantastic congregation, and great things are happening. We'd love to connect with you. So we've got these new cards. They look awesome. I don't know if you've noticed. We have all kinds of things in your pew. There's all kinds of selections, so check those things out. Things for parents, all kinds of ministries happening, and we'd love to connect with you. There's this one here called the Connection Card. So if you are new to the church today, fill one of these out, hand it to Pastor Melody or me. We'd love to just say hey to you. If we're busy slam chatting with people in the back, you can fling it at us like a boomerang thing like this, and we'll try to catch it. It'll work. I don't know why I say the things that I say. And those of you that are worshiping online, we're glad that you're here. I know so many of you are away worshiping online this week. We're back online, which is awesome. Big thanks to Annette and the team for pulling that together. That's worth thanking God for the work and those folks to make sure that came back together. Everybody says, woo. Yeah. For those of you that are communing at home, lift the elements at home, your bread, your wine, when we lift them here, and then share that communion there. And if there's ways that we can be praying over you, please contact us. We'd love to make sure that you guys are well taken care of and know that you're prayed over as well. That is all the announcements that I have, except now you get Pastor Melody.
Yes, yes. There's more announcements. I do want you to check out these lovely cards. We have all kinds, and we'll go through them a little bit at a time just to spread out the love of what's in front of you. I do want to lift up a few dates for you guys. On April 21st, we are having a work day here at church. So wear old clothes to church, you're good. You can wear your Cross and Crown shirt. And we are going to do outside work and stuff inside. It's going to be wonderful after church on the 21st. Then on the 28th, we have a Set Your Roots. If you have been here coming to worship, we want you to be part of our family. And so this is a chance for you to learn more about Cross and Crown Ministries and start getting connected. So set your roots. If you let us know you're coming, because we're going to have a nice meal for you to welcome you in. There are a lot of stuff in the newsletter, so please grab it. There's one more thing I want to lift up. We need a few more bread makers. So this is the bread that we get at communion. And you only have to do like once a month. It's not very hard. So if you will see Annette after worship, if you are willing to a month at a time or twice a year. Okay. No, I said it wrong. Okay. Okay, twice. So a month at a time, twice a year. So it's not that much baking, but you could bake whenever you want. This is a service that you could do at 5 in the morning or at midnight. It's great. And then we have one more announcement. Well, thank you for sharing your gifts in that way. Grace and peace to you from our God and Father, Jesus Christ. Our gospel today comes from John 20. So please stand for the gospel reading. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my fingers in the marks of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hand. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Oh, I just love Easter. And we had a great Easter. The flowers were wonderful. The music was incredible. And the Holy Spirit was present here. You could almost feel it. It was like electricity last week. Oh, I love Easter. And then each Sunday after Easter, we are hit by the scripture of doubting Thomas. This is to remind us that there is some of us that not all believe as well and may doubt. This is to remind us that people are in different places in their faith journey. So let's start by talking about the disciples. These guys have the thickest head you've ever seen. Jesus flat out tells them what he is gonna do. So let's just talk about, because this is Gospels from John, so let's look through John to see what these guys were up to. So if one time Jesus said, "Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up." So, you know, that's kind of like, don't quite know what he's talking about. And then he also says, "The hour has come that the Son of Man should be glorified. Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it produces much grain." Okay, I get that. Like, he's kind of not coming out completely. But in Matthew, we read this. "From that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and chief priests and scribes and be killed and be raised on the third day." Now, if that doesn't tell you exactly what Jesus planned to do, you don't know what. Like, you would think the disciples, they know what's going to happen. They would be at the tomb in 3 days going, "Okay, Jesus, you said you were going to rise. Where are you? Come on." But no, that's not where you find them. You see, also, these guys were with Jesus every day. They would wake up and they would see him heal the sick or bring wholeness to the broken. Jesus would do things that other people couldn't do, like walk on water, my favorite, turning water into wine, you know, or feed the multitudes. And each day these disciples, these men, followed Jesus to learn from him. And they saw what he was doing. He taught them. They knew him better than anyone else. And what were they doing? Were they standing by the tomb waiting for him? No. They were in hiding. They were scared. They feared for their lives. They forgot everything that they had been taught over the last 3 years. So they were alone in a locked room. So this Sunday is sometimes called Doubting Thomas Sunday, but I think it should be called Doubting Disciples Sunday, because that is where we define the disciples at this moment. Now I have a confession. Sometimes I'm doubting Thomas. I'm the disciple that knows Jesus so well, but still doubts. And I bet I'm not alone. We all have doubts, one time or another. I bet even you know 4 to 5 times as many people that will never enter these doors. Because they doubt. It's unbelievable how a person can be God as well as human. It's unbelievable because Jesus didn't take on an earthly throne and overpower his enemies. It's unbelievable that death is destroyed when it still has reign over us in this life. It's unbelievable because how can we have a good God when there's so much pain and suffering in this world? It's unbelievable because there is so much war and hatred in this world, and love and peace doesn't surround us. You tell me. Yeah, preach it. But let's turn back to the scripture and see how Jesus reacts to his disciples hiding in fear. Jesus comes to them behind locked doors and says, "Do not be afraid." Jesus meets them in their fears, in their doubts, in their thick-headedness. Jesus meets them. Then Thomas comes back from wherever he was. And the disciples have yet another story, an unbelievable story to share with them. Jesus is raised from the dead. Now, this is the most unbelievable story that we have heard about Jesus so far. It's outrageous. How couldn't we believe unless we see it with our own eyes? Or with his own hands. Then the next week, Jesus comes to the disciples behind closed doors. Jesus shows Thomas his hands. He shows Thomas his sides. Jesus shows Thomas himself. Himself. Jesus doesn't fear the doubt. Jesus meets Thomas in the doubt. So let me say that again. Jesus meets Thomas in the doubt. Therefore, we shouldn't fear doubt either. Doubt is just the beginning of faith's new discovery of God's grace. Doubt sometimes is in the beginning, or it's in the middle, or even at the end. But that is where Jesus meets us, in the beginning, in the middle, in the end. always in questions, always in doubts. So do not fear doubt, because that is where Jesus comes and speaks. Peace be with you. But Jesus doesn't just stop there with his disciples. He gives them the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, God that is moving all around us, the God that lives within us, the God that speaks when we don't have words, the God that is always with us. This whole thing seems crazy. Jesus came to earth. Jesus did all these miracles. Jesus healed all these people. Jesus died, and 3 days later, Jesus rose from the grave. It's not believable. I mean, it's crazy. Everything that we know about reality and the way things work, it's just crazy. It doesn't make any sense. It's completely upside down. It's just unbelievable. But God's grace is unbelievable. It is in our doubt, in our fear, in our questioning that Jesus meets us. And that is what grace is. And the best part is we have a community here together. And there's two parts of worship that I love so much. It is prayers and confession. Our confession of our faith. So the prayers. We come together and share what is on our hearts and our minds. And sometimes the pain is too real. Sometimes the heartache is too real. Sometimes the struggle is too hard. But we have someone standing next to us that can say the words for us. We have someone on the other side supporting us through these hard times. If we don't have the words, the person next to us does. And then we have the confession of faith, the creeds, where we say we believe in God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And sometimes our doubts overpower us. Sometimes our questions are more than we can handle. But we have someone beside us that can say the words when we can't. That say, I believe, and I believe enough for you and for me. And what's more important, above all of our belief, is that we have a God that believes in us. A God that believes in us. So when we feel like we're in the middle of the storm, we have each other. And that's what we're called to be. One of my favorite songs that I just recently heard from Drew Holcomb and the Neighbors is called Lightning. And let me read a part of it for you. So even when the rain pours down, even when the light seems like it is fading, even when your heart aches, feels like it's gonna break, that's when you sing out loud, hey, hey, we're gonna shine like lightning. Hey, hey, we're called to be lightning for others. So when people are in the storm, when the storm is raging around them, we are called to be that bright light that comes into their life, that can speak when they are hurting, that cries out to God for them, that stands with them and says, I believe. Because if you notice in this scripture, first of all, the disciples were behind locked doors. And then second of all, after they already saw Jesus, they were behind shut doors. How many times in our life do we lock those doors? How many times in our life do we shut those doors? How many times in our life do we put up the wall of question and doubt, and it keeps on piling up and up and up? It is Jesus that says, it is okay to doubt, but Jesus will run after us in our doubt. Jesus will open those doors. Jesus will tear down those walls. And Jesus gives us grace when we question. Because Jesus' grace is great. The grace is awesome and powerful. And when we doubt, because God's grace is so unbelievable, we know that Jesus is there. We believe. Amen. Apostles' Creed together, and if you're feeling confident in faith, speak it loud. And if you're doubting or having questions, listen to the person beside you. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, and descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We have a God that is so good. We have a God that loves us in the doubts, in the questions, in the fears. We have a God that loves us so much that on the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Then again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." We say the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who is in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Come now and feast on the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Know that all are invited at Christ's table. We'll have two lines where we'll have bread, if your hands are outstretched, we'll place the bread in your hand, and then you may dip it into the red wine. There's also gluten-free available, as well as individual cups of wine and grape juice. All are invited. All are welcome to come to Christ's table. Amen.
The Father.
Jesus Christ, oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, what a Savior! Isn't He bear your cross as you wait for the crown. Tell the world of the treasure you found.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen us and keep us in God's grace. Amen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter hope bless you now and always. Amen.
Let's have some fun on this one. When darkness tries to roll over my bones, when sorrow comes to steal the joy I own, when brokenness and pain is all I know, I won't be shaken. I won't be shaken. Why's that? 'Cause my fear doesn't stand For shame no longer has a place to hide. And I am not a captive to the lies. And I am not to leave my past behind. No, I won't be shaken. I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. There's power, come on. There's power. There's power that can empty out a grave. There's resurrection power that can save. There's power in your name. There's power in your name. This voice I fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand.
Church. Amen. Amen. Let's sing this one. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Praise God above the heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son,
postlude coming up if you want to stick around for just a second. Hallelujah. Go in peace. Rejoice and be glad. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.